Yo people, I'm T, I'm Markham, and today we have Pokemon Platinum Nuzlocke. So in the last episode we left off at this location. And between the episodes I managed to train all of my Pokeballs up to, well, level 46 as you can see. Except for Beaver, because he doesn't care. But yeah, we got Betty to level 46, Feather to level 46, Pingu to 47, Muscle and Fireboy to 49. So that is very good. I'm now going to the distortion build, and hopefully, okay, how the fuck do I get in here? Okay, what the hell are these? Where does this lead to? Yeah. Oh yeah, maybe I have to talk to the city, I guess. Yes. But we have to hurry, so I can't jump in by myself, okay. Odd. But I'm very glad that, I managed to train up my Pokeballs as far as I have. This rock slab. It appears to move if you step on a certain spot. I guess in the middle, because the middle is a little bit of a spot that is different than the others. And it is. Well, you get to see Giratina if you keep going down. The distortion will. Are we really traveling downward? Maybe. Maybe not. Considering how everything is different in this world, maybe not. But yeah, I'm really glad how the series is going. Fee! It's Mesprit. But yeah, I'm really glad that we are already here. And we are like in the 22nd episode? I guess? So we are getting quite far. Of course, we still have a little bit left to do before getting to the league. First this, then the... Okay, where do you have to go? This way? I don't know. But yeah, so we have to go and defeat the gym. The last gym. That's an electric type gym, if I would have guessed. And of course we also have to get Giratina first. I guess, yeah, oh god. I hate these controls sometimes, oh god. Hi, Cynthia. The legend of Giratina has been all but forgotten to bit to a few. The legend told of a world on the other side of ours, this world. Where does this world exist, and why does Giratina here alone? There's so much that can't be explained, but we have things to do. Let's build up, we have to find the right way. Yep. Why I'm going this way. This direction. Because you have to go downwards, of course. Okay, I guess even more. This way, maybe? I don't know, it's like a fucking gigantic maze, so... Whichever way we are going, I don't know. At least I will be happy when we are at the bottom. Okay, this is the complete wrong way. I guess maybe to the north. Do I really have to go here? Maybe let's go back. Yeah, this is all very confusing where I have to go. I mean, and every platform that is around here doesn't really lead to anywhere. Wait, did I just make a circle? No, this is down. That's good. At least I found the right way. No, I don't need to go up. Let me go back down. Then to the right. Yep. Okay, we can go even more down. Which is good, because we have to go down. Ah, this way. Hey, it's Cyrus. Shadowy Pokemon isn't here. It better be here, then disappeared somewhere farther down. Was it content merely to interfere with my plan? Incidentally, do you understand the concept of genes? Yes, I do. If it's true, you've impressed me. Genes can be considered the blueprints of all life forms, and that includes humans and Pokemon alike. Genes are contained in a DNA strand. A DNA strand consists of two chains of opposing characteristics in a spiral. If one of the chains were to be broken, the other could replace it. One or the other cannot exist without its opposite. Do you understand where I'm going with this? This is a bizarre world. Time does not flow. Space is stale. Only the shadow Pokeball lives here. This world is the opposite of our world. Our world always the change. It's like the two chains composing a strand of DNA. Two worlds must be balancing each other to remain in existence. Without the one, the other cannot exist. Shadowy Pokemon must play a role in keeping the worlds in balance. That is why it must have interfered and brought me here. Shadowy Pokemon must have made this bizarre world. That's why trying to change our world disturbed it and made it reveal itself. But that's all irrelevant. What matters is defeating the Pokemon and making this world disappear. Won't allow it to interfere with me again. With it gone, neither world will be able to revert to its original state. That's kind of deep, but okay. Okay, that way not. This way it is. God, sometimes these controls are really baggy. This wasn't even the right way. Good job. I guess this way. Yep. Okay, this goes even farther down. So, this must be the right way. Boulders. Ah, with the three lake Pokemon. I guess. Well, one of the three. I think it's guiding me that I have to put the ball and the boulder or whatever down there or something. I mean, I could try. Boom. That one is down there. Yeah. We have to go this way. I mean, I guess I could go left. Yeah, there's another boulder. We missed it. Okay. Ah, yes. Yeah, they are guiding me. For the boulders to go downwards. Sounds about right. So I guess there must be another one somewhere here. Considering there are three lake Pokemons. Okay. Oh god. It's all changing. Oh, yep, that's Giratina. Come on, go ahead. God, this is a bit weird. Hey, it's Cyrus. Do we have to go even more up? Yeah, there's a platform here. That way, is it the right way to go? I guess this way. And maybe here. Yeah, considering it's going downwards, so we still have to do one more boulder. Yeah, sorry, I was just leaving, okay. That must mean that we are going the right way. Which sounds good. Giratina again, which we will catch easily because we have a master ball. Oh god, upside down shit. Oh no, let me guess, we have to go in at the waterfall. Maybe? Yes. Makes sense, the water is flowing upwards, but we are going downwards. We are moving against the flow. Yeah, there's the last boulder that we need, okay. Then we can do some shit. It's a big boulder, yeah. We need to use strength. And that's downward as well. Yeah, now we are at the right floor. Okay, and considering they helped me before, I think the lake Pokemon want me to put the boulder in the right one where they are. I guess. Because why would they be here? Makes great sense because that's not English. Yes. Wow, this one is easy. And then I guess Mesprit is on the other side. Yeah, there's the Pokemon. Boom. Okay, I also saw a city out down here somewhere. Yeah, here. I guess the Pokemon of the lake lakes must have gone home. Instead, they can keep balance against either Palkia or Dialga. Because maybe they can't do that with Giratina. Oops, there's no time for idle chit chat. There's a platform where you have to go. Okay, first things first. I think I want to get missile in first. Because I'm considering, because Cyrus is here, I also need to battle him sooner or later. So let me get my strongest Pokemons out first. Yeah, considering Cyrus is standing right there, so.
I guess that means a final battle.
This is it. Giratina is up ahead. Yeah, but first things first, I'm going to save. Just in case. 22 and 1. Boom. Now the game is saved. So, you were already here. Why do you seek to change the world? If you hate our world, you should just go off somewhere alone. Find somewhere you can live without seeing others. Why should I run and hide from the world and have to wait quietly? My aim is to rid our world of the vague and incomplete thing we call spirit. Freeing ourselves of that, our world can be made complete. That is my justice. No one can interfere.
Yes, but actually I can.
It's over here. Nothing. Okay. I won't lose. Not to that shadow Pokemon. Not in any worthless world. Yep. This is what I thought was going to happen. 5 Pokemons. Houndoom. We should have had Pingu up for this.
So let me get Pingu in.
Flamethrower. That will not do a lot of damage, I guess. That's considering. Still a lot. I'm trying to do Will-O-Wisp, which means that my Pokemon might get burnt if they get hit by that. It's almost dead. Okay, it used a full restore, which is fine. Okay, another purple beam. Will-O-Wisp, oh god. This is not what I want. Okay. Okay, is hurt by the burn. Gyarados, oh god. Think I want missile in. Maybe that's a good idea. I guess. Okay, waterfall. Might not do a lot of damage, hopefully. God, this flinch, fuck's sake. I didn't need that to happen. But at least we have a lot of healing potions left, so... Okay. Okay, yeah, we have to keep healing. Because this Gyarados is strong. Okay, and we drew it, okay. Crobat. Okay, you want to go for Crobat, and I will go for Fireboy. I'm not going out against fucking Crobat with a fucking missile. Okay, let me heal Fireboy right back up with a full heal thing. Because I'm not really interested in that. Yeah, Fireboy. Cross poison. Okay, let me go ahead and hopefully hit a fire blast. Nice. Okay, hit half of their health. Okay, heal Fireboy back up. Withdrew Cold Red, okay. Let me guess, Gyarados, yep. Which is expected. But, therefore we have a missile. Nice. Because we just switched out Fireboy. Try and get a seismic toss in. Hopefully it doesn't flinch. Okay, more than half health already. But god, this fucking Gyarados gonna hit hard. Okay, another waterfall. And I will get another seismic toss in, hopefully. Okay, yeah. Then it will be low health, of course. Yeah. Then we heal again. Don't know if Cyrus will use another full restore or something. It uses Earthquake, that's good. Because that's not a waterfall. This is not super effective against the missile. This is the same amount of damage. Giga Impact? Oh no! Come on, missile. Okay, good job. Good job. Get through it. Okay, what's your next Pokemon? Is it Crobat? Okay, this is what I was expecting. But of course, Fireboy can do some stuff. Fire Blast. Ah, it's poisoned again. God damn it. Yes, hit the Fire Blast. And hopefully kill it in one hit. I'm not really happy if you don't. Nice! Okay, what's your next Pokemon? Yes, with better poison, I will heal you up soon. Honchkrow, oh god. Considering it's a dark. Oh god, I have a little bit of lag. Let me think. What shall I do? What is a good idea? Let me think. I think I want feather. No, let's just keep Fireboy and heal him up. My god, 47 here. Okay, heal up with a hyper potion first, because I think he is going to do a lot of damage. I'm not really happy if it does. Night Slash, god, it's so much damage! Yeah, you know what? I'm just going to speed through this. I will be right back. Jesus Christ, I decided against it to speed through this because, god no. Okay. I hate to see that the two of my Pokemon are doing so bad. But considering Feather is doing a good job against Horsecrow, I guess he also has a psychic attack. Okay, drill pack. There's not a lot of damage. Okay, that is a decent amount. We get a aerial acer. Nice! Yes! Weavile. Oh god. Okay. 48? You know what? Yeah, we need Fireboy in for this. But first let's heal Feather, because I'm not sure how much damage Weavile will do. Considering it's also an ice type, this is not good. Ice Punch. And it's frozen as well. What do I do? What's a good question? Maybe get Betty in, just in case. Accessor. Maybe confuse it? That might be a good idea to confuse it. Hopefully it hits. Okay, yeah, it's now confused. And considering it did an accessor before, I shouldn't risk it. Should just try and heal her and hope for the Ice Punch to hit itself Then I can heal up Fireboy, for example. Come on. Night Slash. Little... God. Yeah, I think I want to heal again, just in case he does an Ice Punch and it hits. I don't want to lose Betty, of all Pokemon. Okay, nice, it's hit itself. Now we can heal up Fireboy. Okay, if it can hit itself again. Yes, it hits itself again. That is good, because now we can also heal him from the poison. Okay, it snapped out of confusion, that's fine. Ice Punch, hopefully it doesn't crit. Hopefully it leaves Betty with a little bit of life left, yeah. Then switch out to Fireboy. Hopefully it doesn't X-Scissor again. Because that happened the last... Okay. I think it's done for Weavile. Yeah, consider it. Oh, fuck's sake. Fucking frozen. First I have to get rid of that. But I'm glad the fucking confusion did its work. Okay, Night Slash. How much does that do? Oh, that is shitty because my fucking recording just cut out. For fuck's sake. But I did manage to beat Weavile with the Fireboy, and Cynthia just healed up my Pokeballs. So now it's time to go and meet Giratina, which you will capture easily, I guess. Giratina is enraged because the two worlds are endangered. It's merged the Distortion World and Overworld at the Spirit Pillar. Therefore, both worlds are becoming distorted. There's nothing to fear. You can defeat the Giratina and show the type ones you share with your Pokemon. Or you can demonstrate how much you wanted to join you. If you succeed in doing either, Giratina will understand. The distortion of the two worlds will stop. Let me go and get Giratina. The legendary Pokeball of this game. Okay. Come here, yeah, 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 yeah. It's Giratina. Here he is, the boy himself. Quietly eyeing Mark. And it's Giratina. As the distortion rolled, Giratina appeared. Go missile. Hell yeah, this fucking music though. Let me just take a moment and listen to it. This is so good. The best ball with the ultimate level of performance. You'll catch any world Pokemon without fail. Well, Giratina, you're about to become mine. Come here, you little piece of shit. Boom. Giratina has caught a main card. Yalala, la la la, yalala, la la. It was banished from its violence. It's silent gaze upon the old world from the distortion world. It's a ghost and dragon type. Which is good. Yes. Dracona. Kind of so similar to Corona, but okay. Your team just seems to have understood us. That Pokemon. That shiny Pokemon was captured? Yes. You're doing so means this irrational world will remain in existence. Does that make it impossible for me to create a new world? Even if you made a new red change, the new world can't be made. Why? Who compels you to protect the two worlds? Is spirit a vague and incomplete thing so important to you? The places we are born, time we spend living, languages we speak, we're all different. The presence of Pokemon unites us. Share our lives with our Pokemon, and our happiness grows as we all become greater than we were alone. That's why we can battle and trade with anyone we choose. Silence! Enough of your blathering. That's how you justify spirit as something worthwhile. That's merely humans hoping to deluding themselves that they are happy and safe. Emotions roiling inside me. Rage, hatred, frustration. These ugly emotions arise because of my own incomplete spirit. Enough, we will never see eye to eye. This I promise you. I will break the secrets of the world. With that knowledge, I will create my complete and perfect world. One day, you will awaken to a world of my creation. A world without spirit. Well, since there's sadness, we can feel joy. With this anger, compassion is born. Let's go back home. Born where Giratina was, should lead back to our world. Giratina was written in legend as being on the other side of our world. That's the reason that it has a link to the other side.
Yep, let's go back.
There's a portal where Giratina was. Will you leap into the portal?
Yes, I will. This place? It's a scent of spring.
It sets somehow lead to the great beyond. Giratina was set to live in a world on the opposite side of ours. I'm so very sorry, it's very rude of me. Mark, you're incredible. You really are a fantastic trainer. Let me say this on behalf of all Sinnoh. Mark, thank you. Oh, that's right. You have to go tell Professor Rowan. I was very worried about you. You should visit him at his lab.
Guess I will, but first, let me check what's up here. Wait, where am I? Considering I have a town map. I'm here. Spring path. Okay. Hey, but this also means that we have the chance to catch another Pokeball. Come on, give me a Pokeball. Motherfucker, you are going to die in fucking hell for this, you little piece of fucking shit. I already have a fucking beer grill, I don't need you. This is what you deserve, you little piece of shit. Well, no more Pokemon for me. Let me check. Spring path. Ah, now we are here. Okay. Okay, let me get Betty and fly to Sand Gem Town. Mark, you've come back. You leave me speechless. You've done it. You really have done it. Never has my heart pounded this hard for so long in my 60 years of living. Professor did a lot of checking up after you left. He was really worried about you, Mark. Contacted acquaintances looking for help and... Mark, I'm glad to see you safe. Welcome back. Oh yes, there was something I had to tell you. Three Pokemon in the lakes appear to have returned to their homes. So tell me, how are things going for you? Pokedex? A total of 175. The total number of badges? Well, we've only got 7 already. That's only leaving Sunnyshore Gym. You've gone this far. Why not obtain Sunnyshore's badge? Why not challenge the Pokemon League? That will broaden your horizons further than ever before. Not to mention the opportunities to meet even more Pokemon. Yep. That is weird. I think I want to leave it. But, of course, for the next gym, I will leave Bibberill in the fucking PC and will switch out Giratina because he will be a good
adjustment for our team in that regard. Okay, you are being stored. Because obviously, if we need the Bimeril, we always can get it back. Snorrent, Garatina, my little boy. What are their moves, actually? Not a thing of it. I haven't even seen it, so... But now all my Pokemon are evenly leveled, that's good. Garatina. Pokemon raises the foe's PP usage. Oh, that's nice. Ominous Wind. Ancient Power, that's good. Dragon Claw and Shadow Force. Sounds good to me. Okay. Well, we have a good team. That's for sure. Bimeril is just for the HMs. He doesn't care. Okay, let me fly. Because I think if I can just get to the next city, that will be good enough for this episode. Because how long are we recording for? 38 minutes. Decent amount. But it also means that I can get 3 Lake Pokemon, which I will not get. So those are going to be difficult spaces and maybe I add, but I can't even talk clearly, jeez. Fucking Pokemon, get away. Shoot. No, dear Ferric. You go back to the cave you belong. You don't really belong in a cave. At least now can go here. It's a new route. Which means new Pokemon! Incoming with the Pokemon! Well, now we've got my interest peaked. Get Betty in.
Hi, Powder.
Let's try to get the Aggro in. Just to damage a little bit. Of course, not kill it. It's more than a little bit. No, not really. Just try to catch it right now. Hey, we got a magnet! Woohoo! New Pokemon to our team. Nice, now we got also a new Pokemon. And of course, just for moral sake, magnet. Okay, now I need to heal Betty. Just a little. And we got a paralyzed heal for Betty. No, but you know what? I will leave this episode right here. So in the next episode, we will go to the next gym and hopefully defeat it. So please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you next video. Bye!